This video is about selective sweeps in HIV. It is an abstract of a paper by my collaborators, Sergei Krishimsky and John Wakely, and myself, Plony Pinnings. Imagine a population with a certain amount of genetic diversity. In this population, a mutation may occur that confers a fitness benefit to the virus. This mutation, and with it the genetic background it arose on, may then rapidly increase in frequency in the population and thereby sweep away genetic variation. We wanted to see if this effect of a selective sweep could be seen in HIV and study it in detail. We had data from a clinical trial that was done in the 1990s. All patients in this trial were taking multiple drugs at the same time. This particular trial was of interest to us because the researchers collected a lot of genetic information from the viruses of the patients. We selected 30 patients to study in detail. In these patients, the virus was not resistant at all at the start of the trial, but it evolved to be resistant to at least one drug later in the trial. The first thing we noticed was that in 28 of the 30 patients, the virus went from having zero resistance mutations to having one resistance mutation. This is surprising to many because it is often thought that the virus needs at least several mutations at the same time to benefit from them. Our second observation was that the fixation of a resistance mutation was associated with a strong reduction in genetic diversity in the viral populations, exactly as we expected during a selective sweep. Our third observation was that genetic diversity recovered again, especially at non-synonymous sites. Our fourth observation was that resistance mutations sometimes occurred through hard sweeps and sometimes through soft sweeps. In a soft sweep, the resistance mutation occurs on two or more genetic backgrounds. Using the frequency of soft and hard sweeps, we estimated that the effective size of the viral populations is around 150,000. Whether this number is high or low depends on your perspective. In the paper, we discuss how our estimate compares to other estimates. By studying viral sequences from patients in a clinical trial, we could see that resistance mutations fix one at a time. We also observed that genetic diversity is lost, but then recovers again. And we observed both soft and hard sweeps. We used population genetics theory to learn about HIV. For example, to estimate the effective population size of the virus. If you'd like to know more, have a look at our paper. It came out in PLOS Genetics in 2014, and the data are available on FakeShare.